We repeat, the flying gimp has been destroyed. You may return to your homes.
And now, back to the Sky Daily Show with tonight's special guest, Ricky Coogan.
Ricky, after your hideous disfigurement, you are showing incredible courage by agreeing to finally show yourself in public.
Thanks.
America has watched you grow up in television and in movies. For years, you were everyone's favorite little brother in that hit series, The Baker's Dozen. And of course, as the star of those hilarious ghost dude movies, well, you got the entire country saying, "Boo, dude!" But now, after your horrific ordeal, the very mention of your name makes children scream in terror. Ricky Coogan, the world is waiting to hear your story.
Well, it's kind of long, but okay. It all started when I was approached to be spokesman for a multinational corporation called EES.
Oh, the Everything Except Shoes people.
Right. I was at their headquarters to meet the chairman and the board of directors. They wanted to send me to South America to promote a controversial fertilizer called Zygrot 24.
You are the only one who can stand up to these radicals who are trying to keep Zygrot 24 from the struggling farmers whose very future depends on it.
Wasn't that stuff banned?
Only in the U.S. and Europe.
I heard that shit's lethal.
All right, you need proof. Fine. Please sit down.
I would like you to meet the head of our South American research facility, Señor Juan Valdez.
My name is George Ramirez.
Whatever. He's been working with Zygrot 24 every day for the last 5 years. And look at him. He's in fine shape. Aren't you?
Juan.
Yes. I am fine. I want you to know that me and my team in Santa Flan...
Santa Flan? What kind of shitty name for a country is that?
It is named for the patron saint of creamy desserts. As I was saying, we have worked very closely with Zygrot 24. I have personally supervised its development.
No potential danger was left uninvestigated. The environmentalists are crackpots. All of them. This is ridiculous, I tell you. Totally ridiculous.
Thank you, Valdez. That'll be all.
Hey, wait a minute.
Ricky, this is important. We are talking about a major threat to the EES image.
How does $2 million plus expenses sound?
Dick, $2 million. Sounds great. But...
I hear you. Let's make it $5 million. Well, that is if the board agrees. Gentlemen, all those in favor?
Good. It's unanimous.
Well, Ricky, what do you say? Are you EES's man in Santa Flan?
So the deal was done. I was Ricky Coogan, toxic chemical salesman. Me and my buddy Ernie hopped on the next plane for Santa Flan.
Oh, did they show a movie?
Return to the Blue Lagoon.
Oh, I heard that sucked.
Where the hell is Ernie?
Ladies, all I wanted was a manicure.
Hey, I'm kidding. What is that, gravy? Where'd you get that?
I don't know, Coog. It started as a pimple and then I scratched it.
Can I get either of you gentlemen a pillow or a blanket?
Yes, please.
Is that your luggage up there?
Yeah.
Is that your ugly little troll?
Stewie, Gluck!
Look! I got a rare still from your first season on the Baker's Dozen! Could you sign it for me, please?
Baker's Dozen, I like the mom on that show.
I porked her.
Cool.
Don't cry, Stewie. Deep down, I'm still good.
Yes!
Take your bomb, sir.
Captain Benway here. To the right of the aircraft, you can see a terrific view of the Grand Canyon. And to the left, you can see a panic-stricken little troll.
You gonna eat your peanuts, Ernie?
Nah, you can have them.
Thanks. Santa Spam, world famous for loud music and hot sex.
It is?
Give me a few hours. Sure glad that wasn't our plane.
Take your toes and crawl away!
Jesus! We better find a limo right now before these whale kissers chop us up and sell us for parts.
I got a better idea. If I can just find the right disguise.
Take these.
Give me back my crutches, you monster! Oh, it hurts! Oh, God!
Are you okay? Let me help you.
Thanks. Oh, don't worry about me. What's one man's pain weighed against the global injustice of corporate tyrants like EES? Go. The fight must continue.
Wow. My name's Julie.
Josh. Josh Tapper.
Mother Teresa, glad to meet you.
Give me those, you ape.
Ow. Oh.
Josh.
Yeah?
A busload of us are headed over to Maracas to protest Zygrot 24 and pelt Ricky Coogan with cow shit.
Same here. You could ride with us.
Us? You're with him?
Oh, Ernie? He's okay. You ever heard of an idiot savant?
Sure.
Oh, that's Ernie, except for the savant part.
Yeah, well, one thing's for sure. That Coogan guy sure is an asshole, huh?
Oh, I'll say, what a total piece of shit. I mean,
Don't you think so, Josh?
Well, he's got a few problems.
And what a lousy actor. I mean, can you believe all that ghost dude crap?
Well, come on, with a script that bad, he deserves an Oscar for coming off as good as he did.
Well, he's no Christian Slater.
Slater? Now, come on, I can act circles around that one note, hack! And you think Slater could improv like this, huh?
So, Julie, you like Swedish films?
You don't even want to hear the truth about Zygarde 24, do you, Coogan? I mean, look, I am not saying that this stuff is going to turn anyone into some kind of...
human worm?
Exactly! A human worm. I mean, that's just absurd. The point is that this product
dog
is a...
boy.
Yeah, or a dog boy. That's stupid. The point is this is a very...
Frogman?
Okay, now you're just being silly. Human suffering is just a big joke to you, isn't it, Coogan?
What?
You are so sick. Cool! A freak show! Let's check it out.
Kind of like a family reunion for you, huh? Lighten up, Coog. Could be a goof.
Freaks is a registered trademark of Elijah C. Scuggs Enterprises. Any unauthorized reproduction is strictly prohibited without prior written consent.
Stupid. Let's go, Ernie. This place is dead.
Yeah, where's all the weirdos?
There are no weirdos here.
Mutants? Yes. Genetic nightmares? Definitely. Children of hell and twisted masses of living, breathing, tormented flesh. Certainly. But as for weirdos, not a one. Unless, of course, you count me.
Nah, you seem like a regular dumb shit old redneck to me.
I'm Julie, and you are?
I am Elijah C. Scuggs, proud proprietor of Scuggs' Fabulous Freakland and Mutant Emporium. But you already knew that. After all, you have ventured miles away from civilization, hospitals, telephones, police. How may I help you?
Drop dead.
We would love to see your freak show. You see, you have built a monument to the variety and innovation of nature. It reminds us to respect the fragile complexity of our global ecosystem.
And you come to me looking for weirdos.
Hey. Hey!
Ah! Ow! Ow! Hello.
Mr. Toad is my assistant. As for the show, I'm afraid the next parade of deformity isn't until tomorrow evening.
Oh.
However, I do have a private exhibit in my shed you might be interested in. I don't usually share it with the general public.
Well, we're deeply honored, but no thanks.
Yeah, you really... All right.
I used to blow up toads with firecrackers, pal. So watch it.
The sideshow tradition has been completely misrepresented by the media.
Ooh.
I mean, you don't traffic in human misery. You show society a part of itself it just doesn't want to look at.
Give me this.
What the hell, huh? Well, we'll see some pickled dog brains. Maybe some pictures of women with, you know, added equipment? Huh?
Why not?
I just love the family circus.
Are you out of your mind?
I do admit, they use the same joke over and over again. I'm just a sucker for this little Moffat shenanigans, that's all. Perhaps I should tell you a little bit more about what I do. You see, I not only exhibit freaks, I make them. Just like Michelangelo, saw the angel in the stone. I can look at a guy like Kevin Costner and see a giant peach grub who can fart the Blue Danube. Behold the Tasty Freaks Machine!
My God! You're using Zygra 24!
Hey, you're not supposed to have that stuff!
Well, then I guess I'm not supposed to have these either! Who wants to get freaked first?
Lady first!
Go screw yourself!
If I were you, I would!
Oh,
oh God!
Let's see now. What should we do with these two? Let's see. Final button eyes, huh? Should we make them deformed? Michael Jackson? That's like yin and yang. ACDC. Birds with windstone. Pretty darn good, really.
Let her rip, Toad!
On us and mutate our body parts?
Correct.
Well, then could you give me like a really big Rodney?
I'm a mad scientist, pal. Not a miracle worker.
I'll never have to go far for a piece of tail.
Pig!
Toad, take them to their quarters.
Bonnie!
You bigot!
A mere party trick. But you, you're gonna be special. Man, this is Red Swan. Fine, thank you. And you? Listen, I have created the ultimate freak, sort of.
Yes, well, see, that's just it. He's not quite, finished. I'm gonna need some more of that, Zagrot 24. Could you, spell that? Yes. Got it. Yes, well, you take it easy too, Raffin. Asshole.
Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. Time to meet and greet the brand new you.
Oh, God, this was my good side.
Still is, if you ask me. Hell, wait till you see what I've got planned for the other side. Welcome to your spacious accommodations.
Great use of the space.
Yeah, I learned it all from Bob Vila.
You know, you could expose these rustic beams and put in a skylight over just one weekend, Elijah.
Give it a rest, Bob. Oh. One of these days, I gotta put a shitter in there.
No problem, Elijah. It's all right here in my new book, Bedrooms and Bathrooms. In fact, if you take this one on 30...
Ernie? Julie?
Over here, Kook.
Are you all right?
Oh, I know that voice. That's the voice that said, cool, a freak show. Let's check it out.
Oh, sure. Blame the woman. Typical.
It's so real. Is this real enough for you? I'm friggin' Quasimodo.
Lighten up, Coog. You're talking to the original tag team of ugly pukes here. Look at this outfit. Come on. Step into the light.
Okay. Here I come.
Revolting. I mean, after all, physical beauty is merely a socially enforced myth that... Oh, shit!
Yeah? Well, you're no Mona Lisa's yourself. You're lucky I got a strong stomach.
And you are lucky I did not bite you!
Get away from me! You
freak! Ha ha ha! I am Ortiz, the dog boy, leader of the freaks.
Kind of like the top dog.
Welcome to hell, Rick. Shake.
No, thanks. I don't plan on staying long.
Huh?
How many of you are there in here anyway?
First, I have a question for you, Ricardo. Who is starred in the film Exorcist 2, The Heretic?
Huh?
Well, perhaps we should ask the Worm. Tell us, Worm, who is starred in the Exorcist 2, The Heretic?
Olivia Newton-John.
Olivia Newton-John.
Rick, you agree or disagree?
This is nuts. This is crazy.
Besides, it was Linda Blair.
Very good. It was Linda Blair. Circle gets the square.
That's cool.
Okay. Julie, Ernie, who's going to be Nosey the Nose Man? What?
Cowboy.
Annie.
The bearded lady.
How you doing?
Suckhead. Hi. The eternal flame. Fire in the hole. Yeah. Nosey the Pinhead. The hideous frog man. And, of course, in the center square, Mr. Paul Lynn! Well, who will it be?
Call me old-fashioned, but I'll go with Paul Lynn.
Don't be an idiot!
He's funny.
Oh. You see, Rick, just because we are freaks, does not mean we do not know how to have some fun, huh?
Get away from me! Get away! I'm not like you! You hear me? I am Ricky Coogan! I am not afraid!
Poor kid.
Well, sucks. Wonder if they're still casting Gremlins 3. Call my agent in the morning.
Look, Rick, all the freaks have been through this anguish. At first, I was blinded by my anger. I admit that. I wanted to wring your neck for getting us into this, but I got over it. Ortiz taught me to channel my anger for the common good.
You wanted to see the freak show.
I thought I told you to shut up!
Honey!
Sorry, Coop. For a second there, I was a total man-hater.
Here. Take it.
So you're a hideous mutant freak. Now, I don't need this. I'm not like those other godforsaken animals.
You're mistaken, Nick. You're exactly like us. We were all normal, healthy folk before we made the fateful mistake of coming to this hellhole at an off hour. When I first came here, I was a professor of lacrophilogy. The study of worms, of course. I was on the trail of the fat, pudgy worm. Mr. Skunk said he had just such a worm in his shed. How could I have possibly surmised that the specimen and myself should ultimately prove to be one and the same? First, the transformation was fabulous. I truly understood the worm's ethos like never before. But those early days of fascination are over. Now, in retrospect, I think the whole thing is a fucking headache. I'd sell my soul just to be able to wipe my own arse.
I first came here as a tourist, looking for some fun.
Nice place!
Then Elijah turned me into a sock. I'm sorry. I'm not much for stories.
When I first arrived here, I was nothing like I am now. I was confused. A walking contradiction.
All right.
So full of questions.
You know, you'd be better off without a dick.
Hey, you can keep the beard.
Oh. Hallelujah.
But now I know who I am. I can say to the world, hey, this is me. I am woman. And I like me. It's rough.
You're one of us now, Rick, whether you admit it or not. It's irrefutable.
You do it.
Hey, mind your business.
Sorry.
Ortiz, you're on me.
Oh, I am not cleaning this up. Ortiz, down, get up.
Well, the ZES guy should rescue me any minute. Then it's back to sunny old L.A. and straight to the plastic surgeon. I wonder how many of my anatomically correct girlfriends will be waiting for me.
I'll be waiting for you, Rick!
Thanks, Stewie. Ah, it's the troll! Wait, Rick, go home! What are you doing here?
Seeing phantom trolls, Rick?
Nope.
Sounds to me like you've developed a telepathic bond. Don't mean you're nuts or nothing. Heck, old Nosy, why, he can smell the future. Lots of us freaks got ESP, and Sockhead, he's got ESPN.
Watch out, Hulkster! He's gonna try the skull cracker!
Shucks, Rick. You're lucky. telepathy like yours only occurs between real soulmates. A bond like that should be cherished.
Wow! I'm Ricky Coogan's soulmate!
In your dreams? Now get lost, troll!
Shucks, Rick. It don't make sense to spurn your soulmate. I reckon that troll could help you if you just let him into your heart.
Once America sees what happened to Ricky, they'll probably send the whole FBI down to save him. I'll probably win a Pulitzer Prize, this scoop, and I'll dedicate it to Rick.
America needs to know. Bert, give Mr. Gluck his fee and show him the way out.
That's okay. I know the way out. Ricky, Dinky! Ricky Coogan's a mutant in South America! My stewardess Gluck! That's me! Ah! No, you've got it all wrong. I don't know anything about that. You gotta believe me.
Yeah, I bet you weigh about 107.
What's giving those damn EES guys?
Something's troubling you, my boy. What is it?
Take a wild guess.
Oh, I think I know what you're going through. You see, I too had an eating disorder.
Quiet, please.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, you are about to witness a cavalcade of atrocities so horrific that I advise the more sensitive members of our audience to leave the premises at this time. Tonight, I am proud to announce several new and original monstrosities, including our star attraction, the Beast Boy. But first, a perennial favorite here at Freakland, sit back and snuggle up to the musical stylings of Rosie the Pinhead!
Sing out, dear, from the diaphragm.
How many feminists does it take to screw in a light bulb?
How many?
Two. One to screw it in, and one to ride my Rodney.
Oof.
Oh.
Oh. No! Oh.
If your coloring is in the autumn range like Maria, I would suggest you try the earth tone eye makeup. Now, as you can see, I've done a lovely French braid on Maria. But I encourage everyone to experiment and use your imagination. The main thing is, just have fun with it.
Check this out, huh?
Because we love to eat fried veal.
Thank you. You've been a great crowd.
first prize, they never called me Puddinghead again.
So?
Don't you see? You must turn your hardship into inspiration. You're an actor, Rick. Your body is your instrument. And with it, you must play your tragic symphony for all the world.
They're going just for you, Beast Boy. You better get out here now.
I'll be right there. Thank you, Worm. I don't know how to repay you for this.
You could wipe my ass.
What a comedian.
Nosy, have I ever told you what a gifted artist you are?
Huh? Now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious summer by the son of York.
I didn't write this. What is this crap?
That I'm not shaped for sportive tricks, nor made to court an amorous looking glass. Hi.
If you're having trouble understanding Mr. Coogan's brilliant reading of this soliloquy from Richard III, please take advantage of the handy subtitles for the culturally illiterate.
Vile figure. Deformed. Sent before my time into this breathing world, scarce half made up. Why, I, in this weak, piping time of peace, have no delight to pass away the time. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
You seem to like it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Rick. Look, I really love this new look you got going for yourself. It's fresh and hip. The kids will love it. But back at EES, I don't think the big boys upstairs are going to get it.
What are you saying?
Well, Rick, what I'm trying to say is that, you're ugly enough to burn the nose hairs off a dead nun.
What a
pot! Hey, shit!
Rick, now you're just being childish.
Show business, morons!
You're all going to hell!
Now that's entertainment.
And now it's time to play
Wheel of Fortune!
Hooray! 1500! Let's see it! Come to Papa! Come to Daddy-O! 1500! 1500!
Let's go! Let's go! All right, 700. All right, Ortiz, is there, an X?
No, see, there is not an X.
Jesus Christ!
Hey, the wheel. Mind if I sit in?
So, now, you do not mind mixing with us. How did you say it? Sorry, mutants.
Look, I'm sorry about what happened at the show. Jeez, I ripped one guy's face off when I'm a social outcast. Can't you just forget it?
Hey, shouldn't you tell Rick about our big escape plan? Excuse me for living.
You have an escape plan?
Listen, Beast Boy. The games are a simple diversion. Beneath our twisted flesh, we freaks cry out for freedom. Oh!
Ow!
Ow!
Ortiz's plan is really ingenious, Rick. You see, he figured out that if we...
I figured out that our escape does not include the Beast Boy. No one may discuss the plan with him, understand?
What's the matter with all of you? You trust your lies to a guy just because he can lick his own balls?
You gotta admit, Coog, it's a hell of a trick.
Fine. Then I'll just come up with an escape plan of my own, then.
I have spent a year studying this hellhole, devising the perfect escape. Do you think you will just dangle right out the door? Ha! Just try it, amigo.
I will.
Rick, wait.
Yeah, Rick. Ricky. Ricker. Come on, Coog. Don't go off half-cocked. Believe me, it ain't all it's cracked up to be.
This isn't one of your dumb movies, Coogan. Ortiz is a good dog, a smart dog. I'll talk to him for you. Don't be stupid. You can't do this without us.
I don't need you, EES, or anybody else. I'll get out of here all by myself. You crud-sucking pus monkeys.
Against the law.
Psst. Hey, you, milkman.
Me?
Yeah, you. I got something to show you. Come around to this little trap door.
What is it?
I just laid a turd. This is a spitting image of Kim Basinger.
Boy, if I had a dime for every time I heard that.
She's naked, too.
Really? This I gotta see. Ah, that's just a regular turd. Looks kinda like Winona Ryder, but... Oof!
To my, den.
Go to the den, boy. Them go in, them never come out.
Yeah, man, into the den with you.
Diet soda?
No, thanks.
Fiddle faddle?
All right. Delicious. So, aren't you gonna kill me or something?
Sure, it'd be fun, but the Beast Boy's a hit.
Look, Elijah, I've been in show business all my life. The public does not want to see disgusting, depraved, violent filth.
Oh? And I suppose Jake and the Fat Man was just a fluke. Hello. Listen, I'm all set to roll here. You've got it. Yeah. Chow to you, too. Jolly son of a bitch. We'll see who has the last laugh, you jerk off. All right, Coogan, listen up. You're gonna be a hideous killing machine. Tomorrow night, I'm gonna finish the job on stage. And then you're gonna slaughter all the old freaks.
and from their ashes you'll rise like a mighty phoenix, only a lot uglier. And then the whole world will... Hey! I told you enough!
So Elijah was going to send you to Phoenix?
No. He was talking about a huge bird. The mythical creature? It's just a metaphor.
Oh.
The point is, Elijah wanted to turn me into a bloodthirsty monster and have me kill all my fellow freaks. But what he didn't know is that I left his den with an important clue.
Look! Another milkman!
Hey, Rick. Couldn't you come up with your own escape plan?
You gotta be kidding me. A dozen milkmen? Isn't that a little unusual?
12 milkmen is theoretically possible. 13 is silly. Looks like one milkman too many, Coogan.
Freaks! Fine then. Go ahead. Hope you like reggae, you flea-bitten bastard.
Be very quiet.
Shit. Look, you'll all be killed. You don't know about Elijah's giant rasta eyeballs with machine guns.
Poor boy's gone off the deep end.
It's suicide, and I can't let you do it.
And I cannot let you stop us.
Come on, Ortiz. Come on, Ortiz.
Be careful, he's rabid. He's a rabid dog. Rick, stick him to him. Stick him to him.
Really swift. You're going to pull an eye out.
Kill him.
Sorry.
That's a lot of milkmen on the same route. No wonder they fight.
Squirrel!
Holy shit!
Two giant rust eyeballs, just like Rick said!
Gosh, if it wasn't for Rick, we'd all be dead!
Hey. Oh, thanks. Ricky's good.
Yeah. What's your plan? Okay,
come on, you heard the Beast Boy. Back to the freak house.
Yeah.
Now!
All I wanted was a hug.
Maybe I was wrong about you, Coogan.
Not again. Ah, well. At least we'll get to try a new position.
Strong enough for a man.
But it's made for a woman!
Give me!
Hey.
Rick, what's up?
Read this. I grabbed it from Skuggs' den.
Buy more Fiddle Faddle. Tape Donahue. Renew subscription to Beaver World.
Beaver World? Where is she at?
After that.
Prepare demonstration for Laughing Man. Receive 5,000 barrels of Zygrot 24.
Elijah's up to something big. We have to stop him.
We're done for! We're done for! I don't want to die! It's the end of the world! The apocalypse!
I haven't said anything yet.
Sorry, I'm not much for timing.
Look, tomorrow night at the show, I'll be turned into an evil super freak and forced to kill you all. But we might have a chance if we act fast. And I'm prepared to be your new leader.
I say we kill him.
And I've got a plan.
I still say we kill him.
If we can just get into Elijah's lab, maybe we can...
Of course. Design an ointment to turn you into a good super freak and program it to make you destroy Elijah instead of us. Brilliant.
Oh, well, actually, I was...
How do we get to the lab?
Right. The worm can dig a tunnel.
God, it's so crazy, it just might work. But you need Zygrot 24 to make the freak sludge, and Elijah told us himself he's run out of it.
Oh, yeah. Well, what if we just...
Yes, exactly! If they've been using Zygrot 24 is a fertilizer around here, then the entire ecosystem must be soaked with it. All we need is a way to extract it from the vegetation, ideally into liquid form.
Right.
Golly! So that's why my milk comes out that weird blue color. I thought the grass tasted funny. Wow, Rick. You're a genius.
That's cool, Rick. Tell me, how do you think of such a plan?
Well, actually, I was gonna suggest we send away for sea monkeys, train them to fire guns, and make a break for it. But if you want to go with this good super freak thing, I guess that's okay. Hey, look at this.
Good Lord. It's the lost city of Nod.
Wow.
It's Old Faithful.
Ooh.
It's my Aunt Gertie and Uncle Sid.
Oh.
It's my bar mitzvah.
Come on, Ernie, let's go.
Wait, wait, you gotta see the one where Rabbi Katz laughed so hard noodle pudding came out his nose. It was...
Dude!
Ah!
Nice digging, worm.
Back off, okay? I have got a real short fuse today. I am cranky, I am bloated, and I have a wicked case of cramps. Don't ask why.
PMS?
Gotcha, freak!
Ah, fool you. Didn't know I did impression, did you?
Hey, guys. Mission accomplished. They've got the Zygrite 24 and they've broken through into the lab.
Magnifique.
Ça va comme sous des roulettes.
No! Can't you see? We're digging our own grave! It's nuts! That's what it is, nuts! Well, maybe you've all got a death wish, but you can count me out! I'm getting the hell out of here!
Nobody get her hurt.
Out of my way!
That shark full of holes, man.
I just want to say...
What is it, kid?
Oh, forget it. I'm not much for dying.
He's better off. It's a blessing.
I've hacked into Elijah's Super Freak program. My God, it's complex.
Okay, guys, we got a job to do. Let's do it and keep quiet, okay? Oops. Now look, from now on, no more screw-ups, okay?
styrofoam cup.
Here it comes. It's working.
Somebody's coming.
It's plugged up.
This is your fault. I will wring your wormy neck.
Preposterous. I have no neck. I'm a worm. Imbecile.
Damn. Sputtered popcorn on.
The tunnel walls are about to collapse.
You go ahead. I'll catch up.
Rick.
Go.
Yeah, go. I'll stay here with Rick.
Come on.
Okay, everybody, listen up. Now we cracked the code and made the ointment we need to bring Scuggs down for good. But I left it in the lab.
Wait!
I found some macaroons and there's plenty for all of us.
I hate macaroons.
Bed with Elijah C. Scuggs.
Damn! It's nice to see you in the flesh, laughing man.
I think we can dispense with the code names, Elijah. We're all friends here.
And to prove it, we brought you a little present.
Rick, is that you?
Who's the troll?
He was asking questions about Coogan, causing trouble. We figured he was one of yours.
Well, I make freaks, all right, but come on, fellas. This thing's pathetic.
Well, you're no Julio Iglesias yourself, mister. Rick!
Oh, no, not now, Stewie. Hey, where are you?
I'm in the lab!
Not only ugly, he's crazy, too. Toad. Gentlemen, I'm not gonna bullshit you. I know my setup here at Freakland looks like small potatoes, but thanks to your Zygrut 24 and my genius, tonight, I'm gonna turn Ricky Coogan into a freak so hideous, it'll be enough to make your stomach turn inside out. It'll boil your brain in its own juices, and it'll make a cold sore that you thought had healed up start bugging you again. It's the dawning of a new age, a new beginning. Behold, Super Mega Freak World! It's really something, huh?
Very impressive.
We'll kick Disney's dead ass.
Stewie, can you hear me? I want you to try and escape. Bring me the can on the floor near the blast furnace.
I like your spirit, Skeggs. But Disney, come on. I like Bambi.
Bambi sucks.
What about the part where the mother got shot?
Yeah, I like that part.
Well, I liked it too.
We here at EES have plans for your gene machine that include everything. Hmm? Well, everything except shoes, of course.
Well, I'd love to see your plans.
Well, I'd love to show them to you. Bill, would you do the honors?
What does today's businessman want? Well, how about a receptionist with six arms, three mouths, and a knockout figure? That would sure speed things up, wouldn't it? Or down at the factory, how do we fight the rising problem of sagging productivity from lazy workers? How about a worker with 12 busy hands, no mouth to talk back, no genitalia or gastrointestinal system to distract him from his work? Sure, it's what we all dream about, isn't it? Well, with this Skuggs-based Zygon technology, these things are not only possible, they are only the beginning. We're poised on the edge of a new frontier limited only by our imaginations. Of course, what happened to our expensive spokesman, Ricky Coogan, was an unfortunate coincidence. On the other hand, profits from these new markets could total in the billions.
Ricky who?
Hey, now hold on. Secretaries, worker drones, where's the fun? Huh? Where's the spark? Where's the unspeakable evil?
I was just getting to that. We are going to impact every field. Cosmetics, military, novelty house pets. And why should we stop with consumer products? Hell, we can design a whole new consumer. A few well-placed drops in the water supply and bingo! It's a whole new master race. And we own the copyright.
This guy's good.
We lured him away from Pepsi.
Right here, right now, we are building a better tomorrow for those who uphold the vision of EES.
Bill, if I could just add one thing. Those who dare oppose us will stand knee-deep in the blood of their children.
So that's it, then. We're all to die. And by your hand, no less.
No, it won't be me. It'll be some inhuman monster Elijah used me to create. As for me, the real me, I'll always be your friend. And before I have to rip your heads off, I'd like to say goodbye to each of you. Worm, I'll miss your brains, the smell of your pipe, and the funny way you always go on talking until everyone wants to strangle you.
Ricky. Come here, kid! Ow! Ah! Ah! Oh, when will it end? When will it end?
Soon. Hi, Rick. Cowboy. I'll miss your good humor, your down-home wisdom. And those frothy milkshakes were utterly delicious.
My pleasure.
Nosy, I never really liked you.
Suck my dick!
Fair enough. Bearded lady. I don't know, we'll always have Paris. Frogman, I think death is probably the best thing for you now. Rosie. Ernie, Julie, I have mixed feelings. On the one hand, I'll always remember you as the best friend a jerk like me ever had and a low-down, repulsive slime ball. On the other hand, I really respect you. More than that, I just wish we'd had the chance to boink.
Oh, Rick.
Today, I make the proudest boast a man can utter. Ich bin ein Freak! I am a freak.
And now the moment you've all been waiting for, ladies and gentlemen, the Beast Boy! With this remarkable ointment of my own design, I am going to transform this half-finished ghoul into the ultimate stomach-turning super freak, dedicated to evil.
Here I am, Rick!
God damn it, kid, would you sit down?
Oh, no!
Shit, move down.
Your ass is mine, Scuggs!
This kid looks pissed! I and I! Kill him!
Machine and go.
Come on!
Right now!
Wait, Rick! Could you sign this first?
Time to die, troll!
Let's go, dickhead!
This over with.
Hey, Dick! What the hell are you doing?
This machine is now the sole property of the Everything Except Shoes Corporation.
What?
Eat shit, yokel.
I knew I couldn't trust you corporate greaseballs! Head for the hill before he gets all of us.
Boy, I haven't seen a stampede like this since the opening night of Itch Star.
Now I rip freaks to pieces.
Kill Nosy! You always hated Nosy!
Please! No, Rick!
Now that's early. Big shoe.
Oh,
kill him, please? Kill him! Kill him! Kill him!
Man, just as I...
Sorry to interrupt you, Rick, but you've been talking for almost 90 minutes and we really have got to go to a commercial.
Oh,
sorry.
You like cheese. You like being a man. That's why you'll like Machismo. Real cheese for real men. Now in a handy aluminum dispenser.
And now, back to the exciting conclusion of Ricky Coogan's incredible story.
Well, let's see. It seemed like nothing could stop me from shoving a spear through Stewie's skull. When all of a sudden, I heard a voice.
I reckon that troll could help you. You just let him into your heart. Your heart. Your heart. Your heart. Your heart. Your heart.
I love you.
You did it, Rick. Attaboy, Coogan.
Sentimental country.
Beast boy, I gave you an order, and you better obey it, dammit.
It's over, Skugs.
You were nothing before I found you. I made you, and I can break you. You think I made you strong? Ha! I've got my DNA cranked so high, you won't know what hit you. I'm a wrecking machine. Ow. I think you crushed my spinal cord. I can't feel anything in my fingers.
Maybe you'll feel this.
No, wait. If you kill me, you'll never find the antidote.
What antidote?
A time-release serum. I baked it into a delicious batch of macaroons. Macaroons. Thanks, so cool. Right.
If you ask me, you skimped on the coconut.
Looks like they took care of Skugs, Chief.
Nice work, Ricky. You'll get a medal from the Vice President for this.
Right. But how did you?
We've been following Skugs for years. Then when we saw Mr. Gluck's article, we knew it was time to move.
So what took you so long?
Well, first, there was that Satan's Child thing on page 3.
Oh, yeah, I read that.
Then there was the case of the house that dripped blood.
Ew.
Holy shit!
It can't be. What the hell are you looking at? Dead meat.
And that's my story.
Ooh, ooh, it's so exciting.
We fixed Coogan's light.
Oh, it's about time. Turn it on.
That's better.
I'll say. How about it, folks? Let's hear it for Ricky Coogan and his freaky friend,
the Bearded Lady.
How you doing?
Rosie, the Eternal Flame.
Lights out, baby!
Cowboy, Frogman, Moosey. And the Worm.
Ridiculous. Just because a man doesn't like macaroons.
Gotcha! Damn, it's about time.
Ortiz! Ortiz!
Hey, Armando!
That's just great. What a story. And what an ending. Elijah transformed by the goop, and he actually looked like...
Exactly like you, Sky, I swear. Same face, same outfit, except he had these really big, hideous feet.
I'm gonna drink your blood.
It's finally over.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Rick! Hey! Rick!
Stewie!
Well, like that wasn't totally predictable.
Well, now it's really over.
Thank God. You know, this whole thing has taught me something. That when man starts impinging on the subtle perfection of the Earth's natural order, the only thing he'll create is havoc.
Right, Coog. I learned something, too. That men and women truly are equals. That the human spirit transcends gender and physical appearance. And thus, it is immune to the petty degradations men may devise.
So true.
Yeah, I believe it was Molière.
Shut up!
Not at all, Bubble.
Freak.